Now, Israel's second biggest lender by assets is trading lower today, actually for a third day in a row. Quarterly profit at Bank Hapoalim has fallen to $181 million, a 6% drop on the year before. Now, that's on the back of a slowdown in banking income and higher debt provisions. I want to get more on this now and head live to the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange. Speak to the chairman of Bank Hapoalim, Yair Seroussi. A very warm welcome to The Pulse to you. And so then let me start by asking you about net income, which beat forecast due to a one-off tax benefit. But generally speaking, financing from current activities reflected some weakness. Do you expect to see a pickup in the coming year?
No, let me just explain. Bank Hapoalim had an excellent result this year. And we are very pleased this morning. We have an increase of 25% in our profits, finishing with $719 million of profit, 12% return on equity. Our competitor came out less than us. We are establishing and repositioning ourselves as the leading bank, the strongest, biggest, and most profitable bank in the country. So today is really a celebration for Bank Hapoalim. After 3 years of hard work, we are back to show the strength of our bank.
But Mr. Seroussi, you did see fourth quarter net income decline, even if it wasn't a drastic reduction. We were talking about 672 million shekels from 713 in the same quarter compared to a year earlier. So, I mean, you're obviously very optimistic about the year ahead, but you must also be concerned about obstacles to your growth and to your performance in the next 12 months.
Yes. Yeah. I would say this year we came, as I said, in 2011 was a good year for the Israeli economy and for the bank. When we are looking at the last quarter, there are some accounting issues, some changes that came out from Bank of Israel, so there is an effect there, which is an accounting effect. In general, we see two parts for this year in Israel. First half of the last year was very strong, second half slower. Our forecast for next year is 3% growth, which means it will be more difficult to come with the same results next year, although we still hope to achieve something which will be not far from that, meaning double-digit return on equity. That's our target as we established at the time, and we hope to continue this.
How will higher capital requirements impact bank lending to the corporate sector in Israel?
Yeah. We see now a wave of increase that we will need to do in capital like elsewhere. I think that what we see differently from other countries is really that on the small to mid-sized companies, we have no problem. And they have no problem financing themselves. The main pressure is coming out of the largest holding companies and others. They really face problems, and the majority of the problems come from the capital markets, less from the banks. The banks are reaching the limit on the large companies, but the main problems that we see at the moment are coming more from the debt capital markets. We will have to see how this is being resolved with increase in equities of these companies.
So how might those low trading volumes, how might the problems that you describe in capital markets impact operating profit in the year ahead?
We do not anticipate from our bank, because of steps that measures that we have taken in the last 2 years, we don't expect much of an effect on the bank or Bank Hapoalim. We look at it more on the macro level. We want to see how this all restructuring helps to continue the growth of the country, and we as bank as well are affected from these effects of growth. But we don't expect much to be on our balance sheet or to be shown. Well, we expect the same provisions to be next year as well.
And so you voiced some concerns there, Mr. Seroussi. I'm wondering, do you think that there is a problem, possibly a credit crunch in the corporate bond sector in Israel?
There is at the moment a wave in which some of our investors are really on hold. I think that prices start to be attractive again, and hopefully will start to shift it. In addition, there were many, many regulations and many committees in recent months, and I think the market is a bit confused. So it's not just the international effect. When we are talking about, for example, the European effect on our books, Bank Hapoalim really have shifted most of his exposure to the U.S. long ago. And I think that what the effect that we see is really coming out of a little bit decrease in exports to Europe. But I think that the majority of the pressure, the crunch that you are mentioning, is really that people have to really get clarity from regulators, and in the moment this will be finished, we will see again the pension funds and others coming back to the markets.
Okay, so not very exposed to Europe, but perhaps a little concern there on the part of Mr. Seroussi about the companies that have issued debt that need to be restructured. Thank you very much, Mr. Yair Seroussi, Chairman of Bank Hapoalim. Good to talk to you.
Thank you.